Hello everyone, in this video let us discuss about the longest increasing subsequence. First of all, we will discuss about what exactly the problem is, and then we will find out what is the recursive relation, how can you solve the problem, and after this we will see how can you solve the problem using dynamic programming. See, there are various solutions that exist for this problem. One of the solution is order of n square solution, and second one is order of n log of log n solution. So we will discuss one of these solutions, and accordingly we will find out how you can easily solve the problem. Let us first analyze what exactly the problem is. So what is this longest increasing subsequence? What exactly the problem is? So given a sequence A of size n, find the length of the longest increasing subsequence from a given sequence. Now what exactly is this longest increasing subsequence? The longest increasing subsequence means to find a subsequence of a given sequence in which the subsequence's elements are in sorted order, lowest to highest, and in which the subsequence is as long as possible, and this subsequence is not necessarily contiguous or unique. I think you could not understand anything from this definition, so this is, I feel I can give you a much better definition here. So let me just explain you with the help of an example, and then again we'll come back from this. Okay, assuming that we have a sequence, so this sequence is 0, 8, 4, 12, 2, 10, 6, 14, 1, 9, 5, 13, 3, 11, 7, and 15. Now from this given sequence, we have to find a subsequence which should be increasing. Okay, let us assume that if we take 0, so 0, I can take 0, I can take 4, so 4 is greater than 0, so obviously it is increasing. I can take 12, I can also take 10, so 10, it is also increasing. After 10, I can take 14, right? So 14, after 14, I can take 15. So you can clearly see that these numbers are not exactly one after other, but again, there is some differences. I mean, there's some gap. For example, after 10, I've taken the number 14, and after 14, I've taken the number 15. So it doesn't mean that these numbers are continuous, but still, they should be in the same sequence, right? And we have to find a sequence here, subsequence here, which should be longest. So for example, here the length of the sequence is 1 2 3 4 5, so total length of the sequence is 5. So we have to find a subsequence which should be long, as well as everything, all the numbers should be in an increasing order. So that is why we have to find longest increasing subsequence. Now I found a subsequence here which is having total of 5 elements, but still, is there a subsequence possible which is having a greater length? So let us see. So we have an example this here. I mean, we have an example here. So if I take 0 from here, then I take 2, then I take 6, then I take 9, after 9 I can take 11, and after 11 I can take 15. So I can easily find a subsequence here, and the total length of the subsequence is now 6. So obviously this subsequence is longer as compared to the previous subsequence, and the total length of this subsequence is greater as compared to the previous one. So this exactly is your longest increasing subsequence. So now coming back to the definition, so let us read the definition again. Maybe you will be able to understand the definition more clearly now. So it is, the longest increasing subsequence means find a subsequence of a given sequence in which the subsequence elements are in sorted order. Sorted order means either it is in increasing order or it is in decreasing order. So because we are discussing about the increasing subsequence, that means these elements should be in the increasing order. Okay, and there is lowest to highest, in which the subsequence is as long as possible, and it is not necessary that it should be unique or contiguous. So we can have more than one longest increasing subsequence for a given sequence. Let me show you the help of an example. So if you see it here, we have taken one example in the previous case. Now for the same sequence, there are more than one longest increasing subsequence that are possible. So the previous example that I have taken, in that example the length of that subsequence was, how much was the length? 6. Now again, for the length 6, there are more than one such subsequences are possible. We can have 0, 4, 6, 9, 11, 15. So 0, 4, 6, 9, 11, 15. So this can be one subsequence. We can also have 0, 2, 6, 9, 13, 15. So 0, 2, 6, 9, 13 and 15. So you can also have more than one such subsequences. So but what I am interested is, I want you to write a program which can actually analyze what is the length of that longest increasing subsequence. So there are two types of programs are possible here. One, you have to write a program where which is just telling what is the length of the longest increasing subsequence, or I can ask you to write a program which will actually give this subsequence, which will actually find out what is the length of that longest increasing subsequence as well as what exactly the subsequence is. So for simplicity purposes, right now we are just trying to find out what is the length of that longest increasing subsequence. Okay, so let me take more example here. So these are some of the examples we have. If you have an array here which is of length 5, now here the longest increasing subsequence is of length 3. So what is the subsequence? That is 3, 10 and 20. So you can clearly see it is increasing, so as well as it is longest. So the length of this longest increasing subsequence is 3. So for simplicity purposes, we are just trying to find out the length using our program. Now if you take another example here, so we have 3 and 2, so longest increasing subsequence will be 1. And if I take this example where we have a sequence which is 53, 10, 7, 40 and 80, so here the length of the longest increasing subsequence will become 4. Okay, so I hope now you understood what exactly the problem is, and now we will move on and we will try to find out how can you create a solution for this. So I want you to pause the video right now and think about it. How can you write a program to solve this problem? Let me give you a hint. You can write a recursive function. You can write a recursive function. First of all, try to identify, does there exist a recursive relation to solve the problem? And using that recursive function, you can write a recursive program and then try to analyze what will be the time complexity of that recursive program. Okay, so let me give you the solution now. So this is one of the approaches where you can write a recursive function, and it is longest increasing subsequence of I is equal to 1 plus maximum from j is equal to 1 to I minus 1, longest increasing subsequence of j if a of I is greater than a of j and it is 1 otherwise. Let me show you with the help of example what we are trying to say here. Okay, assuming that this is the array. Now in this array we have 3, 4, 1 and 5. For simplicity purposes, let us take the index locations as 1, 2, 3 and 4. So because I'm just writing an algorithm here, I'm not writing a program. So whenever we write an algorithm, we start the index locations from 1 for simplicity purposes. So I'm just assuming that here in this array, we have 4 elements. So I'm giving them index locations as 1, 2, 3 and 4. Now let us assume if I want to find the longest increasing subsequence till the index location 4. So this is the index location 4. So here you can see when I say LIS of I is representing the index location. So what is LIS of 4? LIS of 4 is it will be 1 plus maximum from each of this, maximum from longest increasing subsequence of length 3 and longest increasing subsequence of length 2 and longest increasing subsequence of 1. I mean to say, if I want to find the longest increasing subsequence till this index location, so that will be 1 plus what is the longest increasing subsequence you can find till this index location 3. What is the longest increasing subsequence you can find till this index location 2? And what is the longest increasing subsequence you can find till this index location 1? And whatever the maximum value is, you have to take that maximum value and then you have to insert that maximum value here so that you can find the solution. Let us see again recursively. This is again a recursive call because it is a recursive solution, so this is again a recursive call. So again, if I say LIS of 3, so that will be again, it will be it is 1 plus maximum from what is LIS of 2 comma what is LIS of 1. So what is the longest increasing subsequence you can find till here comma what is the longest increasing subsequence you can find till here, and then you can add 1 to this. Okay, again, if you want to find LIS of 2, so this will be again 1 plus LIS of 1. So basically this is the maximum value we have taken. So here I have written maximum value, here I have not written any maximum value because again it is not required because we have only one value, right? And here LIS of 1 is there, fine. So LIS of 1, we can discuss about it, right? So now if I say LIS of 2, LIS of 2 will be again 1 plus LIS of 1. So what exactly this relation is? What is this relation? So if you see in the previous case, if you see here, so I have taken that it is maximum from j is equal to 1 to I minus 1 LIS of j if a of I is greater than a of j. I mean, if the index location which is pointed by this is greater than this value, then we have to take this situation, right? If this is not valid, then we cannot take this situation. Okay, now if LIS of I is 1 whenever we have only 0 values. So if I take between these two, if I take 1 and 5, so 5 is greater than 1, 5 is greater than 1, therefore for this specific case this is valid, right? So if LIS of j, I mean this is valid, we can easily find it out. For this specific case we can find it out, right? Because 1 is less than 5, so this is valid. If you see 4 is less than 5, therefore also this is also valid. If you see 3 is less than 5, therefore this is also valid. Okay, now if you look at the second case here, we are discussing about this index location 3. Now this 4 is not less than 1, right? So therefore this is not valid, it is not required, right? As well as this 3 is also greater than 1, therefore this is also not a valid recursive call. Now if you look at this LIS of 2, so if you see this 3 is less than 4, therefore this is a valid recursive call. Fit and fine. Now look at it carefully. Now the only thing that you need to know here is that when you have only one element, when you have only one element, so LIS of 1 is only 1. Okay, I mean if you have only one element in an array, so the longest increasing subsequence is always 1. If you have two elements, so the minimum value can be 1 and the maximum value can be 2. So here LIS of 1 is only 1, right? Because longest increasing subsequence of length 1 is 1. Here also this is be 1. So if I say LIS of 2, LIS of 2 will be 1 plus 1, which is 2. So that is, if you look at this index location 2, so sorry, look at this index location 2, so what is the longest increasing subsequence till this index location, which is 3 and 4. This is the longest increasing subsequence. If I take LIS of 3, so in case of LIS of 3, this is not valid, as well as this is not valid. So dono jo aapke paas, these are not valid. So if I say LIS of 3, so this is only going to be 1, because we are not taking these maximum values, so this is again 1. So what is the maximum value between these three? In some way, maximum value, what is the maximum value? So maximum value is only 2. So if I take LIS of 4, LIS of 4 will be 1 plus 2, which is equal to 3. So that is the longest increasing subsequence that you can find out in this given subsequence. So this is how these recursive calls are working. I hope that you understood it, but if you could not understand it, let me explain you one more time with one more example. Okay. So this is the same example here, and as you can see, what we have done is this is the array which is 3, 4, 1 and 5. Okay. Now I can take one more example, then I can show what is the recursive calls, what is the recursive substructure. Let us assume that we have an array which is having the values which is 3, 4, 1, 5 and assume it is 9. This is the array. Index locations are 1, 2, 3, 4 and 5. So initially what we are doing is we are taking j here. We are taking j here. So that means I want to find LIS of 5. That is, what is the longest increasing subsequence that you can find till this length 5. So this value should be 1 plus maximum from each of this, which is LIS of 4, comma LIS of 3, comma LIS of 2, comma LIS of 1. So if you look at it here, so this LIS of 4, that is 5 is less than 9, so therefore it will be a valid recursive call. This LIS of 3, 1 is less than 9, therefore it is also a valid recursive call. This 4 is less than 9, therefore it is also a valid recursive call. This 3 is also less than 9, therefore it is again a valid recursive call. Now if I want to find LIS of 4, that is going to be 1 plus maximum from LIS of 3, comma LIS of 2, comma LIS of 1. Fit and fine. So again, you can see in this fourth location we have 5. So 1 is less than 5, it is a valid recursive call. 4 is less than 5, it is a valid recursive call. 3 is less than 5, again it is a valid recursive call. In the same way, if I want to find LIS of 3, so this is going to be 1 plus LIS of 1 plus maximum from LIS of 2 and LIS of 1. Correct? In the same way, if I want to find LIS of 2, so LIS of 2 will be 1 plus LIS of 1. Okay? Now if you look at this LIS of 2, that is this 4 is not less than 1, so therefore this will not be a valid recursive call. So 3 is not less than 1, therefore it will not be a valid recursive call. Fine. So if you look at these values here, so this recursive call will not be used, this recursive call will not be given. Okay. So look at this value. So this is also a valid recursive call, this is also a valid recursive call, this is also a valid recursive call, as well as this is also a valid recursive call. So again we have to find out this value. So this is going to be 1 plus maximum from LIS of 2 and LIS of 1. And this is going to be 1 plus maximum from LIS of 1. So if you look at these values here, this is, again, we already know that this is not a valid recursive call, this is not a valid recursive call. And LIS of 1 is always 1, LIS of 1 is 1, LIS of 1 is 1, and LIS of 1 is 1. So whenever we have LIS of 1, we are going to keep that a value as 1. So here, from this recursive call, we will get a value 1, because this is 1 plus maximum of this. So this value 1 will be given here. If you look at this recursive call, this 1 is here and 1 is here, so this is 2. So the maximum value from here in these three values is 2. So this is 1 plus 2 is 3. So LIS of 4 will be 3. In the same way here, LIS of 3 is 1. Here if you see LIS of 2, it is going to be 2. And LIS of 1 is 1. So what is the maximum value out of all of them? So the maximum value is 3. So 1 plus 3 is 4. That means in this given sequence, the longest increasing subsequence will be of length 4. And what is the longest increasing subsequence? That is 3, 4, 5 and 9. It is the longest increasing subsequence. So this is the way how we can do recursive calls. But the problem with this recursive call is that there are a lot of problems which are overlapping. For example, we already found LIS of 3 here and we are also trying to find LIS of 3 here. So this is a overlapping sub problem. In the same way, we already found LIS of 2 here and again we are trying to find LIS of 2 here, and we are also trying to find LIS of 2 here. We already found LIS of 1 here, LIS of 1, LIS of 1, LIS of 1, as well as LIS of 1. So there will be many recursive calls. So in the worst case, if you have a subsequence like this, if this is a subsequence which is having the values 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, up to so on, n. So in this subsequence, there will be maximum number of recursive calls. And all these recursive calls, most of the recursive calls will be a overlapping subproblem, the problems which are repeating themselves. Now to implement this function, to implement it, I can simply write an algorithm, I can write a pseudocode to implement it. I'll show you the pseudocode, don't worry. And then I'll show you how can you implement the same concept with the help of your dynamic programming. Okay, so let me show you with the help of this example. So now this is a function which is implementing the same kind of procedure that I've explained you. So in this function, you can clearly see that if I say the number of elements are 0, then we cannot find the longest subsequence, so it is going to be 0. If you have a number of elements as 1, the only one element is there, so in that case, LIS will be 1. Now, if we have an array here, so which is A, now we are calling this function recursively and we are storing the result in M. So here you can see, let us assume that B is the subsequence with only elements less than A of n. So we are trying to find what is the maximum value from m, comma 1 plus LIS of B of 1 to h. So we are trying to find what is the maximum value you can find. So this is the same function, the same procedure that I have explained you. So there are various different implementations of this procedure you can easily find online. So there are many different procedures like this that are available. A lot of different kind of pseudocodes are available. So again, I think you understood how this procedure is working. So maybe you will be able to understand the pseudocode. So now, because we are having many recursive calls which are repeating themselves, so what we can do is we can apply a dynamic programming on this. And this will be your bottom up dynamic programming. So we are going to store the recursive calls from bottom to up, because we already know that LIS of 1 is 1. So now we can go upsides, upwards, so that we can find the values of other LIS, right? For example, if I say we have this array which is 3, 4, 1, 5. Now here, the LIS, if I say I is equal to 1, in that case LIS of 1 is 1. If I say I is equal to 2, so LIS of 2 will be 1 plus maximum of LIS of 1. So that means, is this value 4 greater than 3? Yes, it is greater than 3, so LIS of 2 will be 2. So I can maintain an array, like for example, if this is your array which is 3, 4, 1 and 5, I can take one more array which is representing LIS. So just for simplicity, I am explaining you how I can take this array, but again without this array also you can do it. So here you can see each value is representing LIS of one index location. Okay, if I say LIS of 1, so LIS of 1 will be 1. If I say LIS of 2, LIS of 2 is going to use this value, so this is going to be again 2. Why? Because 4 is greater than 3, so it is 1 and 2. If I say LIS of 3, so LIS of 3 will be that is LIS of this value. Now you can clearly see this is going to be 1 plus maximum from LIS of 2 and LIS of 1, right? But you can clearly see this value, if I try to find LIS of 2, so this value 1 is not greater than this, so obviously we cannot use it, as well as this value 3 is not less than this, so obviously we cannot use it. So this is again going to be a value 1. So LIS of 3 is going to be 1, because 1 is less than 3 as well as 1 is also less than 4. In the same way, I can also find LIS of 4. How can you do it? So it is going to be 1 plus maximum from LIS of 1, comma LIS of 2, comma LIS of 3. So I can take what is the maximum value out of these three. And we have to identify this 5 is greater than 1. Yes. So obviously I can take LIS of 3. Is 5 greater than 4? Yes. Obviously I can take LIS of 2. Is 5 greater than 3? Yes. I can take LIS of 1. So I can take the maximum value of these three. So maximum value of these three is 2. So 2 plus 1 is 3. So this is how I can easily find the solution of the same problem using dynamic programming. It's a very simple implementation. So you can see how big the difference is. If I do not use a dynamic programming, so this procedure takes n into 2 raised to power n as the time complexity, which is very huge, n into 2 raised to power n. But if I use the same this procedure again, so this is an iterative algorithm, and this solution is basically order of n square as a time complexity. So you can clearly see what we are doing here is we are taking an array A. So this is your original array A, which is having all the numbers from index location 1, 2, 3 up to so on n. We are taking another array L. So this array L is storing the LIS index location 1, 2, 3 up to so on n. Now every time we are trying to do LIS of I is equal to 1, first of all. So if I talk about I is equal to 1, so if I say I is here, so in this index location we are trying to store 1. And then we are using this j from 1 to I minus 1. Okay. So I is here, so j is going to be running. For example, if I say I is equal to 3, then j will be running from 1 to 2. Okay. So this second loop is trying to find what is the maximum value from the previous values. So I think let me explain you with the help of example. Maybe you will be able to understand it more clearly then. Without example, I don't think so. I can explain it properly. Let me explain with the help of example. So this is your iterative solution. And let me take these values, which is 3, 4, 1 and 5. And this is represented by your array A. Index locations are 1, 2, 3 and 4. Then the second line says array L is equal to 1 to n. That means I have to make another array, and this array name is L, and it is 1, 2, 3 up to so on 4. Now we are taking L of I is equal to value of LIS ending from 1 to I. So that means if I say L of 2, That means what is the longest increasing subsequence till the index location 2. If I say L of 4, that means what is the longest increasing subsequence for till the index location 4. Now for I is equal to 1 to n, L of I is equal to 1. So here I'm going to make this value as 1. Now for j is equal to 1 to I minus 1. So the current value of j is 1 and the current value of I is also 1. So this is your I, which is 1, and this is your j, which is also 1. So you can see j is equal to 1 to I minus 1, right? So obviously if the value of j is 1 and the value of I is also 1, so this value is of j we are increasing. Now if a of j is less than a of I, so that means if this a of 1 is also less than a of 1, so because this is the value of j and this is the value of I, so you can see 3 is not less than 3, this condition is false, so we will not execute it. Again after this we'll again go back to this statement, and next time the value of I will become 2. So when the value of I is 2, so we are going to make L of I is equal to 1. So in this index location 2, I'm going to make the value as 1. Now for j is equal to 1 to I minus 1, so j will run from 1 to 1. So we are going to check if a of j is a of 1 is less than a of I. So value of I is 2, a of 2. So is 3 less than 4? Yes, this condition is true. So I'm going to make maximum of L of I comma 1 plus L of j. So L of I value is 1 and 1 plus L of j, so this value is going to be 2. So this is 1 and this is 2, because the value of j is 1, so it is 1 plus 1, that is 2. So I'm going to put a value 2 here. So after this again we'll come back here and this value of j will become 2, and now this 2 is not equal to I minus 1, 2 is not equal to I minus 1, so this condition is failed. So we'll come back to this for loop. Again next time the value of I will become 3. So I'm going to make L of I is equal to 1. So I'm going to make this value as 1. And then for j is equal to 1 to I minus 1, again the value of j will become 1 if a of j is less than a of I. So a of j is 3 less than 1, that is false, so this will not be executed. Next time the value of j will become 2. So again, is this value 4 less than 1? Again this condition is false, so again this value of j will become 3. Now this condition will be false, and again we will come back to this for loop. So again next time you can clearly see here that the value of I will become 4. So when the value of I will become 4, it will be again the value of j will become 1. So we are going to check, is this 3 less than 5? Is this 3 less than 5? This is correct. So I'm going to make L of I comma L of 1 plus L of j. So this is going to be 2. Again I'm going to check. So value of j will become 2. Again I'm going to check, is this 4 less than 5? Yes, you can see 4 is also less than 5. So I can make this, what is the maximum value between 2 and 2 plus 1? So see, this value of I is 2 and this value of 1 plus L of j is also 2. So it is 2 and 3. So we'll make this value as 3. Again we are going to increase this value, and next time the value of j will become 3. So when the value of j will become 3, we are going to check whether this 1 is less than 5 and the condition is true. So again I'm going to check that L of 4 is 3 and L of 1 is 1. So this value is 1. So again I'm going to check what is the maximum value between 3 and 2. The maximum value is 3, so I'm going to keep this value as 3. So after the end of this entire function, this is an iterative solution, after the end of this entire function we can easily return the value of L. So the maximum value of L is 3. Hence you can clearly say that the longest increasing subsequence till this last location is going to be 3. Now this is an iterative solution, and you can easily find out what is the time complexity of this iterative solution. So this for loop will run n time, this for loop will also run approximately n time. So basically it is n minus 1 again, but so you can clearly see because of outer loop and for loop, the total time complexity is going to be n square. So I'm not going in deep into time complexity, I can easily find out the time complexity from the very basics, but I've already explained you how can you analyze the time complexity in these cases. I've already created many videos based on this, so that is why I'm not going very deep into time complexity. But you should understand the time complexity for this function is going to be order of n square, okay? So this is the iterative solution that I just explained. So the time complexity is order of n square, and the auxiliary space, that is extra space that we are using, is order of n. So the extra space is order of n because we are using this extra array, so which is equal to the same size of the original array. So hence the auxiliary space is order of n, and the time complexity is also order of n. So again, there is one more solution that is available for this problem. So this is something that I have already explained, so you can see the pseudocode. Now there is one more solution for the same problem, which is order of n into log of log n time complexity. I have not explained that solution. Maybe in the upcoming videos I will explain that solution, but I think this is a very quick video. I think you understood what is the longest increasing subsequence. I hope that you like the video. Please like and share with your friends, and thank you so much for watching.